Hey guys, welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'm gonna be showing you guys how I created this look right here. This is the first time that I'm sitting down and doing a full face of makeup. I'm talking full glam, full eyeshadow. It feels so good to be back playing with my colorful shadows. And I know you guys are probably thinking, oh gosh, here she goes again, using the same Carnival palette, the same Love Tahiti. But no girl, okay, I did not use my Love Tahiti palette or my Carnival palette. I'm actually using this Ace Beaute Oceanic palette. It's not a super new palette. It definitely did not just launch, but it is brand new to me. I've had it in my collection for a while and never got any use out of it. So I wanted to play with this palette for today's look. Also because I wanted to use the shade Limelight from P. Louise again in a different way so you guys can see how versatile those bases are. So I did use that eyeshadow palette today, but also I'm using a ton of new makeup. So we're going to be using the Catrice True Skin Hydrating Foundation. This is actually the new shade that I got. I told you guys I purchased this the first time. It was way too light. This shade is even way too light. You guys, when I tell you that I have color, like look at my shoulders. Like I have so much color right now. None of my foundations match, so I had to make it work. I also did use the new Anastasia Beverly Hills Cream Bronzer. Super excited for this. I know you guys were too. And then I also did use the Dominique Cosmetics Blur and Moisture Serum Primer, which just looks like this. So a ton of super exciting things in today's video. Before we jump in to today's video, I wanted to talk a little bit about Dossier. So you guys know I've worked with them before, so I'm super excited to be working with them on today's video as well. So if you guys do not know who Dossier is, it's basically a perfume brand that creates fragrances inspired by your favorite high-end perfume. So they have women fragrance, they also have men fragrances, and you guys, they're super, super affordable. They start at just $29, which is such a steal, and you get a huge bottle. It's amazing. So I did pick two scents this month, so when you actually get your order in the mail, this is what the box looks like right here. It just says Dossier on the box itself. And when you go ahead and open it up, you have your fragrance, which comes like this in this cute little box. And then it does come with a card as well. So this is basically like your information card. So it tells you the scent, it tells you the notes, it also tells you which high-end fragrance it was inspired by, as well as how this system works. So it's super cool. I know that it's very difficult to pick fragrances online. Obviously, you guys cannot go in store and smell them. However, they have a great return policy, which is always on your card. So basically, you can open the fragrance, you can try it out. If you do not like it, you can return it and get your money back. It's 100% guaranteed. Obviously, you're not gonna go there and use half the bottle and then expect to return it and get your money back, but lightly use it for a day or two. If you don't like it, it's not your favorite, you can return it. But I think you guys are gonna love it because I have quite a few perfumes from them at this point and I absolutely love them. Every single time I wear them, I get so many compliments and people never know that it's not a bougie $125 bottle of fragrance, and it's Dossier. So this first one that I got this month is called Floral Honeysuckle, and this one is inspired by Gucci's Bloom. It is so good. You guys, I actually sprayed it on this little card before because I wanted to make sure that it wasn't going to smell bad. And oh my gosh, it's delicious. So I picked up that one. And then the second scent that I got for the month is called Floral Pink Pepper. And this one's actually inspired by Dior's Misty Ore. So again, it comes with the card, basically like your little information card. Super cool. I also do have a discount code with Dossier that I will leave down below in the description box in case you guys are interested, as well as the website to Dossier. You guys know I would not talk about anything if I do not truly believe in it. And when I tell you guys that these fragrances smell identical to the ones that they're inspired by, you're gonna be amazed. So thank you so much to Dossier for working with me in today's video, and let's go ahead and jump in. You guys, so let's go ahead and get started. So of course I'm going to be using my P. Louise base. If you guys are new here, this base is amazing, and the way I personally like to apply it is I do a few dots all over my eyelid. I do smaller dots, but I do a lot of them, if that makes sense, instead of putting like a glob of base on my eye. And then I go in with a buffing brush like this one. This one is from Morphe, if you guys are interested. And I basically just tap out the product until it's completely blended. This is also going to help because you're going to see that the base is going to go from looking really wet to kind of having like a satin finish. And that's when you know it's ready to go. So as far as eyeshadow palettes, like I said, I'm going to be using the Ace Beaute Oceanic palette.
it. I don't have the palette in front of me. I cannot even find it for this voiceover right now. So I'm first going into this blue shade, and I'm going to be using this to start to carve out the shape that I want. By the way, it's always when I'm doing my voiceovers that my dogs decide that they want to eat. So if you hear crunching in the background, that's what it is. But like I said, I'm going to just use this as my guide. So I did this eye shape a little bit different, a little unusual. So clearly there's no blue on that outer part, but I'm using it for now as a guide. So that's basically going to tell me exactly how high I should bring my cut crease, if that makes sense. So that's going to get removed eventually, but I wanted to at least create the shape and create the illusion so it can help me to make sure everything is symmetrical, if that makes sense. So I'm going to go ahead and start to blend into the crease now. I'm taking a small blending brush and just building up that blue color, because now that I have the shape, I can start to create the blend. So that's what I'm doing here. And then I'm gonna go into the green shade in the palette. This shade is so beautiful, you guys. I'm obsessed with it. And I'm actually gonna use this shade to go ahead and blend out that darker blue. So I'm using the same method that I always do. Half of my brush is on that blue and half of my brush is on my bare skin. So that way the two colors mesh together really well. So that's what I'm doing here. And then of course, after I'm done building that green, I'm gonna go in with an even fluffier brush so that way we can actually diffuse that green. And there's a lot of color going on right now, but keep in mind, we still have to cut the crease. So a lot of this color is gonna be gone and removed from the lid. So now that the green is nice and blended, of course, I wanna build up the intensity. So I'm gonna go back in with that darker blue just to build up the intensity to my liking. So that's what I'm doing here. And also there's noise outside as well. They're doing construction in the house right next door. So yeah, kind of out of my control. I'm sorry, you guys. So moving on to cutting the crease, I'm taking a Q-tip and just some micellar water as usual. And I'm basically going to create the shape of the cut crease that I want. So as you guys saw, this is a full cut crease. So that's what I'm doing first. And this method is so easy, you guys. It makes your life so much easier. And then I'm just gonna take a makeup wipe and of course remove the rest of that color. And do you guys see what that method did? It just gives you the perfect shape, the perfect line. It is just perfection. Okay, it's a little bit of an extra work, but it's okay because the end result is going to be so worth it. So now to go ahead and fill in that blank space that we created on the lid, I'm going to use the P. Louise base in the shade Blank Canvas. And this takes me forever, but basically I like to just tap it on and I work in sections, if that makes sense. So just take your time with this, but yeah, like I said, I take forever. So let's go ahead and fast forward. So now what I'm going to do is just start to blend out that base, and I'm using that same domed buffing brush that I used to actually apply the base before we did shadow, just to blend out that blank canvas, because it is thicker than the original P. Louise base. So once it dries down, it is like cement, okay? And it's not gonna go anywhere. So now we're gonna work on the outer corner of the eye. I'm taking a flat angled brush and I'm just going to use this to connect that outer corner to the top where that cut crease ends. Now, you could have left the shape how we started it in the beginning and just blended it as you went, but I wanted something more precise, so that's why I completely removed it and then recreated it once I had the crease nice and cut. And then as far as creating the blend on the lid, I'm just taking a fluffy brush. This is meant to look messy, it's meant to look faded, it's meant to look blended, so you don't want to use a packing brush for this. So I'm keeping that darker blue at the bottom, as you guys can see, very close to the lashes, and then I'll gradually go into a lighter blue, and then an even lighter blue, and then here I went in with the light green, just to mesh everything together, so that way at least the lid looks a little bit cohesive with the crease. And I loved this method, and it is so easy. You're literally just tapping on eyeshadow until you're pretty happy with how all the colors are blending together. So now that everything is pretty much blended, I'm pretty happy with how everything turned out. I'm gonna go ahead and clean up that outer corner. Super simple and easy. I just took a makeup wipe to create that really sharp edge, and now we can move on to lashes. So to actually prep my lashes for falsies, I'm gonna be using the L'Oreal Air Volume. I love this mascara. It's so bomb, you guys. And then for lashes today, I'm actually using these lashes here, and I'm so excited because the brand actually sent these to me and they're so beautiful. I'm gonna leave the name of the lashes down below. They also gave me a coupon code for you guys, so if you're interested, you guys can check them out because they're absolutely beautiful. All right, you guys, so lashes are on. Eyes are pretty much done for now. So moving on to primer, I'm going to be using the Dominique Cosmetics. This is the Blur and Moisture Serum Primer. This primer was amazing. I've seen so many good reviews. I haven't even seen not one person say they don't like this. And this is going to be my new go-to primer. It is so bomb, super hydrating, and also gives your skin a really beautiful, soft, focused finish. For foundation, like I said, I'm going to be using the Catrice True Skin Foundation. This foundation is really beautiful, you guys. It has really good coverage and it's so skin like, so it's very rare that I see a foundation that's so full coverage but still looks like skin and doesn't even look like heavy, if that makes sense. It's so beautiful. Also, it's super affordable. It's Catrice. I know it's super hard to find right now, but if you can get your hands on it, I definitely recommend that you guys give it a try because it is so beautiful and the coverage is absolutely amazing. So for cream bronzer, I'm going to be using the new Anastasia Beverly Hills cream bronzer. Mine is in the shade Golden Tan. This shade is nice. I could actually have went a little bit darker, but I will say that it was extremely blendable and it was also extremely buildable. So although I felt like it was a little bit light, I took my time and built it up and the color was absolutely gorgeous. Moving on to concealer, I wanted to try out this Nude Stix concealer. I'll leave the shade name down below. This was not my cup of tea, you guys. I'm just gonna be honest with you. I have to try it again a few times. I feel like you can't really get your full opinion using something one time, but the coverage just was not there for me. You guys know I like a full coverage concealer. However, this might be something that'll be good for like just an everyday natural no makeup makeup kind of look. So I'll give it a try again and I'll let you guys know what I think. So I went ahead and set my under eyes off camera with that Jaclyn Hill palette, and now for the rest of the face, I'm gonna be using the Artist Couture pressed powder. This one right here is in the shade Cream Puff, and oh my gosh, you guys, it was so beautiful. It's not a powder that's going to give you more coverage, in my opinion. It's so finely milled that it's basically just going to set down your liquids, but the way it sets it is just unlike anything else. It makes your skin look so smooth. It's beautiful. And then for bronzer, I wanted to use an oldie but goodie because I needed some color. This foundation was a little bit pale, and my face was looking like a completely different color from my body. So I'm using the MAC Mineralize Skin Finish in the shade Dark Tan. And then for blush, I'm going to be using this blush palette. But first, I was like, I want to go in with the cream blush first. So this is the Jaclyn Hill Cosmetics Cream Blush Stick. This one specifically is in the shade Swoon, which is the really pretty orange one. You guys, first of all, she said that you can actually use these over your powders. So my face is completely set. You guys saw me set it. And it did not move my powder. It didn't get blotchy. It didn't get patchy. I was shook. Okay, I went ham with it. As you guys can see, I'm not being gentle. Like, I'm really pressing that brush on there. And it was beautiful. It didn't disrupt my makeup whatsoever. I was so impressed with this. Like, I couldn't get enough. I was like, are you kidding me? So I'm so happy that I got other shades. Have you guys tried these yet? Because if you haven't, you definitely should give them a try because I am so impressed, and this might be my favorite cream product as far as blush ever because I can use it over my powder. It's so easy. So that's the blush, and then I did go into the blush palette, and I'm going to be using the shade Tea Room mixed with a little bit of that lighter pink, and these were very pigmented, okay? I went a little ham. I had to take my face brush that had the excess powder left over to just go over that blush because I kind of went a little overboard. So moving on to highlighter, I'm going to be using one of the new Jaclyn Hill Cosmetic highlighters, and you guys, these are wet looking, so beautiful. I'll leave the shade name down below, but that's basically it for the face. So moving back into the eyes, I'm going to go in with that dark blue on a flat definer brush. This is the Morphe X Jaclyn Hill flat definer brush. It is my favorite flat definer brush of all time. It is so good. I'll leave it down below in case you guys want to check it out. And I'm basically going to pack that color super tight to my lower lash line, and then I'm going to blend it out with a blending brush. Next, I'm going to go back in with that bright green, and I'm taking that same blending brush and just diffusing that underneath the blue. It's going to create like that blue-green kind of tone, and then I went back in with the flat definer brush just to re-intensify everything. So for the waterline, I wanted to show you guys how versatile these P. Louise bases are. So this is the P. Louise base in the shade Lime Light. Now, these are safe to use on your waterline, which is what I'm doing here. As you guys can see, I'm using a very tiny detail brush and I'm packing it on little by little because you don't want to get this in your eye. I also wear prescription contacts, so I definitely don't want to get this in my eye or on my contacts. So you want to be very careful, but the trick to these are to put them on the waterline, but then you want to actually set them in place with a powder. So for today's look, I'm going to go back in with that lighter green powder from the Ace Beaute palette. And I'm basically just going to tap it over the base. So it's essentially drying down the base. It's setting it in place. And when I tell you guys that this is not going to budge, it's not going to budge. And it's also going to be super vibrant and beautiful. So that basically completes the shadow. So now I'm going to go ahead and add some lower lash mascara. This is the MAC Giga Black Lash. And I did my lips off camera, but we can go ahead and set everything in place using the Morphe Luminous Setting Spray. One of my favorites, very affordable, and the mist is amazing. And I can't find any of my fans, so I just had to use this empty box. But this right here is the completed makeup look. What do you guys think? I think it's so beautiful. I'm obsessed. The colors are gorgeous, and everything pretty much worked out well. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye, guys.